You know, it's hard to believe that this sturdy monster started out like this. Yeah. Just last year, I was growing my first Jolokia pepper indoors to get it started to grow outdoors during the summer. And it was during the winter that I got this one started, and it got tall, it got leggy, and then I showed a procedure on how to prune your pepper plants. A lot of you have tried this method with great success, and I think it's fantastic that you're trying some of the things I'm teaching and you're actually finding some good success. I'm gonna bring you in closer and I'm gonna show you how to prune a plant to make it look really, really nice. This one is pruned, this one is sort of pruned, but I wanted to bring you in and show you what I do and how I do it. And what do I do it with? Okay. All right. Now, once the plant gets about a foot from the soil, I want to clip it back. And this may look really drastic, but those of you that have done this, you know that it works. And I'm going to show you the results of what this can do. I like to take it back to about halfway. Oh no. Now that we've taken this off of the top, it may look a little bit, I don't know, sad. But, oh, well, roots are showing. Okay, but it's not sad. What it is this has a lot of roots. It had enough roots to take care of all of that that we just cut off. Now, with all of that energy and that capacity for growing, it has nowhere to put it except right here where the new buds are. It's going to send out new shoots really fast and furious. It will show a lot of change really, really fast, and that's fun. Now, what those will do is they'll grow out, and then when they get about maybe, I don't know, 8 inches long or so, we're going to snip those back a little, and then they'll put out even more. They'll put out like maybe four more, and four over here, and we'll snip those back, and it turns into this pyramid effect. And what it also does is it forces this stem to get stronger and stronger. So when your plant gets full grown, it already has the strength. It has the low center of gravity. Instead of a really tall plant, it has a very low center of gravity to support really heavy yields. And isn't that what we're growing these for? Now, pruning is so simple, and it doesn't have to be scary at all. Here's the basics. We don't want things to grow into the center. We want them to grow out, because as they grow out, they get stronger, and they also open up the inside to get more light. More light means a stronger plant, and especially when you're growing it indoors, you want to maximize the amount of light. So if this is all growing into the center, it's blocking the lower leaves, and they're not getting the light, so they're basically a hindrance to the plant, because the plant is working to keep them alive when they're not pulling their own weight. Makes sense, doesn't it? So we want to open up the inside and have it go out in a V formation like this. That way it can get the maximum use from whatever little light we have. This is growing kind of to the inside. Sorry, no can do. You have to go. Same thing with this one. This is kind of going into the inside. Sorry. You're not functional. You gotta go. Now, the rest of this branch is going out that way. This branch is going out that way. Oops, see this one? You probably already saw this one, didn't you? This one's going towards the inside. Can't let it do that. You want to clip off everything that is growing in and leave the things that are growing out. That is the key, because you want this to grow out while it's inside, and that way it can develop the strength, the structure, so that when it goes outside and it starts producing these peppers, this is gonna be a strong branch. The fruit is going to be hanging down here. It's going to be a beautiful, beautiful plant. Now, anything that is down at the bottom, you want to make sure is well pruned, because you don't want a whole bunch of plant down here. All right. And one last thing I want to bring up. This thing is due for a haircut, and I wanted to do it for you to show you how I do this. Pineapples grow extremely large, even in a tiny pot like this. I cannot believe this monster. And it is time for this guy to get a haircut, because I just don't have the room. What I do is I just take my clippers and I slice these at a 45 degree angle. I don't know why, it's just because it looks good. Slice the leaves back to where they're just under a foot long, and do this all around the plant. It is just that easy, and it's not going to hurt your plant at all, because these pineapples put out 10 times more leaves than they can possibly ever use in this lifetime. And especially like when they're indoors, they really do not need all of that crap. And if you slice these leaves off, it buys you a lot of time. And a lot of us do not have the room, me included, by the way, for big old honking monster pots for every single plant we own. I just don't have the room. You know, I have a nice grow room, but come on, even I have limits. So I trim these leaves back It gives me some walking space so that I'm not poked in the face every 5 minutes by a pineapple plant with an attitude. And it also keeps the plant from sucking up as many nutrients, and it buys me some time to where I don't have to transplant it into a bigger pot. This thing right here can now survive in this pot a lot longer, and it's still going to produce fruit. It will not prohibit this from producing fruit. It has more than enough leaves, and it doesn't look really quite so bad. It's a little bit more believable instead of that crazy, 6-foot wingspan it used to have. My little tip on pruning your pineapples. I hope this works for you. So to wrap it up, folks, with just a little bit of creative pruning, some good soil, and creative lighting, you can grow just about anything that you want, from lettuce to cocoa trees to pepper plants that are stronger than Godzilla. Yes, you can do it indoors. It's really not that difficult. If you ever have any questions, concerns, advice, let me know in the comments section, send me a private message, or join me on Facebook. Yeah, I know I keep mentioning Facebook, but the cool thing about Facebook, if you ever have gone there, there are some really nice people over there. And on my page on Facebook, I keep it family friendly. I don't allow cussing. I don't allow any kind of spamming, any kind of garbage like that. So you can go over there with your family, with your friends, with your kids, and you can have a really good time. It's safe. It's fun. It's very educational, and it promotes fun gardening for all of us. And I think that's pretty much the focus of what I want to keep it on. Keeping it fun, keeping it green. I think I gotta go now. I've had too much coffee. Thanks for joining me up in the grow room. This is Ray. Bye, everybody.